So after, okay guys, read the question first. A line AB measuring 65 mm long. So 65 mm long is our true length of the line. A is 20 mm above HP, 25 mm in front of AP. In this data, we can complete locus of A dash in the front view and locus of A in the top view. B is 40 mm above HP and 65 mm in front of AP. What is this data? With the help of this data, B is 40 mm above HP. So I can complete the locus of B dash in the front view, 65 mm in front of VP, locus of B in the top view. Draw the projections of AB, find its two inclination with HP and VP. So if you, after reading the question, if you identify what are all the data, how you are supposed to use the data in your answer or in your projection of line means, it will be easy for you to solve the problem. So first step, you have to draw XY, VP plane above XY and HP plane below XY. First step is you have to fix locus of A dash and locus of A. So A is 20 mm above HP. For that, you can make a common projector. Above XY it is 20 mm, below XY it is 25 mm. 20 mm above XY, A dash, below XY it is 25 mm. In front of VP, make a point as A. Complete the locus of A dash and locus of A. Okay. Now you fix the point B, locus of B dash and locus of B. So for locus of B dash, 40 mm above HP, you draw a line or projector, it is 40 mm above HP, complete the locus of B dash. Okay. For locus of B, it is 65 mm in front of VP. In the top view, you can complete, you draw the same 65 mm long in the in front of VP. So 65 mm below XY, identify the locus of B. So this is locus of B. Now all the locus of A dash and B dash as well as locus of A and B in the front and top view is completed. Now you check it, what is the true length of line 65 mm. You take A dash as center, 65 mm as radius, cut the locus of B dash. Okay, A dash as center, 65 mm as radius, using compass, you cut the arc at locus of B dash. Afterwards, you can join A dash at the cutting point, draw a line. Okay, nothing but true length of the front view, A dash, B1 dash. If you obtained any true length line in the front view, now it will be easy for us to complete the after making a line A dash B1 dash as parallel to XY, then we can complete the top view projection. How we supposed to make it as parallel? Extend the projector from locus of B dash to locus of A. From locus of B dash to locus of A. From the point B1 dash, extend the projector, make it as correspondingly B1 in the top view. Afterwards, you can make A as center. A as center. This B1 corresponding to B1 dash, this point B1 you can make it as radius, draw an arc to cut locus of B. Afterwards you can join the A and B, make it as A and B, you can make it as top view. This is our top view. Okay, how we supposed to find the front view with the help of true length in the top view? What is the procedure for drawing true length in the top view? A as center, what is the true length? 65 mm as radius, draw an arc to cut locus of B. So from A as center, 65 mm as radius, draw an arc to cut locus of B. After finding out the B2, so we will move on to identifying the front view. The same procedure. Now you have to extend the projector from locus of B to locus of A dash. So locus of B, where I supposed to start? From B to extend the projector until it cuts the locus of A dash. Okay. After identifying B2 dash in the front view, B2 dash in the front view, now you can take A dash as center, B2 dash as radius, draw an arc to cut locus of B dash, nothing but front view point B dash. So So draw an arc, A dash as center, B2 dash as radius, draw an arc to cut locus of B dash, make it as point B dash. Now you can complete front view. Okay, now the problem is solved. After completing front and top view projection, check whether both the B dash and B lying on the same projector. Yes. So now read the question. What are all the data they asked? Or you have to represent all the given data in the question. 65 mm you have to represent as true length. You can represent either in the top view or front view. That is your best. As per your convenient and your space availability on your paper, you can either draw on the front view or represent in the front view or top view. Okay, so you have to identify true inclination with HP and true inclination with VP. Using protractor, you can identify the A dash B1 dash inclination is the true length. A dash B1 dash inclination is true length, theta is equal to 18 degree. For marking dimensions, don't draw as it is what I have represented to you. You have to draw an arc. At both ends of arc, you should have a arrowheads. Okay, if the dimension is too smaller, you can use the arrowheads in the outside the line. Okay, so next question, I have to identify inclination with respect to VP. What is the inclination line? AP2 is the true length. So inclination of AP2 is phi is equal to 38 degree. Okay, and complete the question by writing down all the answers. True inclination with respect to HP theta is equal to 18 degree, with respect to VP phi is equal to 38 degree. Okay, this question is solved. So same pattern, instead of true length, they have given the, what is the difference between question number 3 and 4? After reading the question, you can identify. The distance between the two projectors of points is 70 mm. A is 10 mm above HP, 15 mm in front of VP. B is 50 mm above HP and 40 mm in front of VP. Find the shortest distance between AB by rotating line method. If you check the question more or less same, instead of true length, here they have given the shortest distance between two projectors is 70 mm. First of all, what is the projectors? Two projector is A and A dash, we are joining by means of one line. It is projector 1, and another projector is another end point of the line is B dash and B. By joining B dash and B in the front and top view by a projector is the next projector. So the distance between these two projectors is 70 mm. They have given this data instead of true length compared to the problem number 3. So up to that, the procedure is same. You have to fix point A, locus of A and locus of A dash and locus of B and B dash in the front and top view. Okay, so we will proceed the problem. XY, VP and HP above and below XY. Fix the locus. A is 10 mm above HP and 15 mm in front of VP. Draw a projector 10 mm above XY, 15 mm below XY. So 10 mm above XY is nothing but front view A dash, below XY is 15 mm, it is A. Complete the locus of A dash. Here you can fix 15 mm below XY and A as the representation. Complete locus of A. Okay. Now you have to fix point B. For front view it is 50 mm above HP. So 50 mm above HP, you can draw a line and make it as locus of B dash. 40 mm in front of VP, below XY it is 40 mm in front of VP. So 40 mm below XY in the top view. Complete locus of B. Here you, after completing all these things, you may stuck. What I supposed to do now? What is the data left out from the question is distance between the two projector. So anywhere on the XY you can mark 70 mm. Okay, mark 70 mm and complete the projector. Okay, complete the projector. With the help of this projector, now it will be easy for us to complete the front view of line AB as also the top view of line AB. So we will start from the front view. This is the, after completion of this projector at 70 mm, B dash and B, we can draw a line to complete front view of line AB. Okay, so A dash B dash is completed. If the front view is known, now you have to rotate and extend the projector to identify the true length in the top view. Okay, so rotate A dash as center, B dash as radius, draw an arc to cut the locus of A dash. Okay, A dash as center, B dash as radius, draw an arc to cut locus of, here it is A dash, here it is B dash. Using compass you can make A dash as center, B dash as radius, cut the arc to locus of A dash, then mark it as B1 dash. Okay, now you can extend the projectors from B1 dash to locus of B. Extend the projector from locus of, sorry, B1 dash to locus of B. Okay, now you can join B1 and A. Now you can join A and B1, A in the top view, B1 in the top view. So you can complete the true length of the top view, true length in the top view. Okay, true length in the top view. So next we have to project the top view of projection of line AB. Already we extended the projector, you can join AB, it is the completion of top view. Now the same procedure you have to repeat what you did for obtaining the top view true length. So now from the top view projection I have to rotate for this A as center, B as radius, A as center, B as radius, draw an arc to cut locus of A, then extend the projector till locus of B dash. Okay, extend the projector till locus of B dash. This is nothing but B2 dash. Okay, so join A dash and B2 dash as the true length of the line AB in the front view. True length of the line AB in the front view. Now you have to read the question. Find the shortest distance between A and B by rotating line method. Nothing but they are asking the true length of the line AB. You can measure in the front as well as top view. You have to get more or less similar value. Accurately, if you have drawn, means you will get same value in true length in the top view as well as in the front view. Based on your space, you can represent either in the front view or top view. So the length it shows by measuring using scale, it is 85 mm. This is the answer of shortest distance between A and B is 85 mm. Then inclination with respect to VP and HP is asked. So inclination with VP and HP is asked. With HP, theta is equal to 28 degree, and with respect to VP it is phi is equal to 17 degree. Here you have to mark an inclination using protractor for true length line, because they are asking true inclination, they are not asked front view inclination. Okay, so they asked true length inclination. You have to mark the inclination of line A dash and B2 dash as theta respectively in the top view, AB1 as phi is equal to whatever the measurement you are getting it from the protractor, you can make it, mark it. Okay, after completion of problem, write down all the answers. What is the question? The shortest distance between A and B is 85 mm. True inclination with respect to HP, theta is equal to 28 degree. With respect to VP, phi is equal to 17 degree. If you have to use all the instruments carefully, then only you can obtain the exact answer inclination while using protractor for measuring the inclination. Okay, so make protractor for measuring the inclination. Make sure this answer will be correct, because we already started using the distance between the two projectors as 70 mm. So you will get exact answer.